Hello, I'm Dr. Amulya Shetty. I'm a consultant psychiatrist. I'm practicing currently in Malad, Borivali and Kandivali. Today I'm going to be talking about troubled teens, how to identify troubled teens and how parents can help the troubled teens and how to cope up with the problems. Teenagers are very difficult. Parenting a teenager is the most difficult thing in the whole parenting area, especially when they start changing their behavior, especially at the age of 12, 13, the behavior changes. The child who is completely dependent on the parent starts not looking at the parent's face, starts having a different thought process, start ignoring the parents. So it's difficult for parents to understand the sudden change in the teenagers, but it is important because this is the most important stage where a personality is formed for a teenager, so it helps in them in the adulthood. So how do we identify the difference between a normal teenager and a troubled teenager? First, change in appearance. Usually all the teenagers try to change the way they dress, they change the way they behave, they want to wear different clothes, they try to change the hairstyles. When do we realize the teen is troubled? When they start having a lot of self-harm cuts, they start trying or talking about suicidal, they start suddenly shaving their head. So this indicates that this is not just a normal teenager behavior, but there is a trouble which is causing the person to behave in a certain way. Second, mood swings. Teenagers are seemingly have increased mood swings, repeated irritability, depressive features and everything, but that also can be just in the normal teenager. When the mood swings, it's a different, it's pathological, will be when an adult or when a teenager starts showing a lot of tantrums, throwing a lot of things, gets very abusive verbally and uses a lot of bad words, then we know that this might stem from a different part of teenage trouble. It might be an anxiety, it might be bullying in school, or it might be even depression. Third, smoking or drinking or using substance. Most of the teenagers, and especially in this time, start at least experimenting on drugs like smoking or drinking, or even some people try marijuana, that is cannabis. But when they do it on a system, when it becomes like a habit, when a person starts building up with peers who are trying to do only substance, then we know that the teenager is going into the substance abuse or substance dependence. That is an immediate action that we have to start taking treatment. Fourth, decline in studies. Once they're 13, 14, there's sudden change in syllabus, the person goes from 10th standard to 11th, so there's a lot of decline in studies which happen. But a significant amount of decline, for example, a person, kid who scored around in 9th standard 80 to 90%, suddenly doesn't even clear or flunks in a next exam. We know that there is a significant amount of stress or an anxiety or depression which is happening, that this is a trigger sign that there's something else going on. So immediate action has to be taken during that time. Then fifth, changing the peer group. Everybody, especially in teenagers, prefer friends more than the parents. They would like to hang out more time with the friends. They feel friends' advice is more taken more from better than the parents, which is a normal teenager, which every teenager would do. But if they're completely shutting off the peer group, that even particularly if they have a certain group of friends and they suddenly switch from a group of friends to somebody else who are negatively influencing them, then we know this is not just a normal teenage behavior, but this is something to be alarmed about. So these are the things which you know that how to identify a troubled teen. And some warning signs, like if they start talking about suicidal behavior, if you hear about bullying problems in school, if you hear about some abusive languages which has been continuously told, or in females we also see a lot of sexual inclination to the men more than the normal it has to be, then these are the warning signs which has to be addressed as immediately as possible. Now how do we treat it? And it's easier to tell than done, because parenting, anything you say to a teenager, he's going to take it on the negative side. The first important thing is communication. The more you start communicating and treating them like an adult, it becomes easier for to treat the teenager. You sit with them, have a particular set of timings, and then talk to them as their language. If you talk to them like a senior telling them rules and regulations, they're never going to listen to the whole complete part. Second, give them this space. Whenever you realize they've done a major mistake or they're not really dealing with the problems they have to, give them space, let them cool down and let them realize that probably what I'm doing is too much. If you start telling them you're wrong, you're completely, you cannot do this, then it becomes very difficult to handle them and they're going to go against you. And third, have a particular rules and regulations to be followed. There is a good schedule you have to follow as a parent. The proper timing of food, proper sleep, proper hygiene, proper education, everything has to be given in a particular time. There has to be not much of a difference by when you're doing that. And fourth, involve in every activities. That is, whatever they're doing, try to push them into sports, try to push them into any extracurricular activities, and identify every signs and symptoms. If you feel your child is going away, don't shut them off completely. And fourth, control your anger. Most of the parents, when they see a teenager completely behaving differently from what they're supposed to be, they get very angry and they show the complete anger towards the teenager. That will not solve the issue. We have to control our anger, have a lot of patience, and then if you communicate with your teenager, they might be able to understand you. So this is the sum of the tips you can do for handling a teenager. It's a difficult job, but it can be done, and things definitely keep improving. Thank you for watching the video. For more information, you can contact www.lybrate.com.